Hi everyone, I am Amit. I welcome you all to the From the Scratch podcast series. This From the Scratch podcast episode is going to be so informative because we have a guest. We have a special guest and he's an influencer and he influences people by his knowledge on investment, marketing ideas and business ideas. So today he's with us and like this specific episode, we are going to learn each and every minute. So stay till end. To all the listeners, if you're listening on Google, Apple, or on other Spotify podcasts, or if you are watching on YouTube. So let's not waste the time. Let's introduce to the man himself, Samar Pawar. Hi, Samar. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing great, Amit. And thanks for such a wonderful introduction. And I would assure your viewers and listeners today that they will definitely take some really brilliant ideas from this interview. They'll get real valuable information from my end, and I can assure everyone, those who are listening and watching it.
Lovely. So really, that's what we are expecting, and even I am so much excited to learn from this and from you on this specific podcast. So Samar, like, just before getting into the podcast, I just want to tell you like how I got to know about you. One of my closed one, he told me and he shared your Instagram profile by saying, bro, look at his content. It's worthy. Each and every post are so value added to your life. So I was just going through back and I've seen so much value you're putting and I've read, like I got engaged and we had a short conversation and now that is turning into a long podcast conversation. Yeah. So like in brief, could you tell to the listeners about your existing work and like, what are you doing? Even I want to know that.
What am I doing exactly? I do lifestyle blogging primarily. When I quit my SEO job, I was SEO manager in digital marketing agency and I used to work there and I had a team of 7 people and I used to give a SEO training as well. Afterwards, when I shift to my own business in 2011, I had started blogging. And that day, I had decided I would do something really big in blogging part. But that hadn't gone with a plan. I had switched in many things and that everything happens for a good. So in during those days, I learned lots of additional skills. And I have worked with MNC clients. After I quit my job, I never had imagined I would be able to give the value to such big company. And afterwards, I thought, why not just shift myself? Why am I looking myself as a blogger only? So now I am into social media marketing and alongside, I've been working on many projects. For example, bloggers outreach project I just finished for Timex and Hitachi. And this is not my direct project. This is came from few digital marketing agencies. I am helping them out for completing their work. And alongside, I run my four blogs. This is about motivation. This is about health, and this is about influencer marketing. And I am very active on Quora as well. I write for Quora, and now I am a part-time trader. I do stock market trading as well.
Lovely. Your profile looks very huge.
And I can't actually limit myself into a specific genre because I believe there are so much things to learn. Like if you visit my page on Instagram, when I started it, I used to think, what would I share? But when I sit on my laptop every day and I thought, what should be the today's topic? I get humongous ideas and I just write it down and post it. And people loved it and I would definitely feel. And I get many replies from my followers on Instagram that after reading my post, they just got so much motivated and they have started their business. So that's an achievement for me right now.
That's a great achievement. Yeah. And like, Samar, like whenever I have a conversation with a guest on this podcast, like what I do is like, I take them back to their like school and college days. To know their mindset towards career, towards their business or towards what they're going to do or what they're going to become in like after school or college. So I'm just curious to know what was your mindset back in the school and college days? Like what you wanted to become and like, yeah, could you open up?
I was very average student. You know, when I used to be in my 10th standard, I got failed in 9th standard. Then afterwards, I did 10th standard from Patrachar that used to happen in my years. And afterwards, I took admission in school again. So when I was in my college, I was pursuing English honors. And that time I got motivated from Mr. Bill Gates and Steve Jobs. I decided I would do college. I would drop my college and pursue my other dreams. And I decided to take retail management. I did retail management for a year. Afterwards, instead taking a job in the retail sector, I moved to a finance sector. Means, can you see, I was very confused person in my younger days, and I was doing retail management, then I moved to finance sector. Afterwards, I decided to shift to a digital marketing thing because that time internet was on a boom. So I thought, why not just try this thing? And I am a bit lazy person. I love to sit on my laptop for 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 hours without any. You don't offer me any food. But if I am with my laptop, I am very much instantly gratified. Feel gratified ki ho gaya mera aaj ka. So this is how it had started, and I thought I will pursue my career in internet only. I won't choose retail, but I won't choose retail or finance. But I thought I should go with the retail part. Oh, sorry, digital marketing part only. So I got a job in my SEO for very rapidly. I got my first job after 6 months of self-training. I got a job in this industry, and afterwards the things had started.
Yeah, and the three industries you worked, all the three industries are booming now. It may be finance, it may be digital marketing, or you told like one more was
retail, finance, and digital marketing.
The three are booming now. And as I can see in your content, also Instagram post, you are mostly like putting out content on these things. So my next question is also coming on these things. Like, as we all can see the current crisis of Corona, so we all see everywhere, like mostly we are hearing about positives, and that positive is something bad. But in this podcast, I just want to hear some other positives, the positives which are upcoming opportunities in India, some positive opportunities in India. So just want to know what's your perspective?
Trust me, when I had posted this idea that collapse of China and rise of India, I actually delete negative comments when I get people got offended. From this idea, how can I say that collapse of China and rise of India? They were pushing me. They were actually trying to, they were trying to harass me in some manner with their bad conversation in a bad language that you are living in a dream world and that won't never get happen. And I am telling you on your podcast today, the next decade won't, the China definitely will get collapsed in some manner, and the rise of India will definitely happen. That nobody can underestimate this statement right now. And I know there are many people, those who can't see the future. I am telling you, this is going to get happen. And for Indians, this is the big time. If you invest in your learning, if you invest in your study, if you invest in your business, you will get humongous amount of business, humongous amount of client base, humongous amount of export opportunity, humongous amount of digital opportunity. In retail business, you would get so much opportunity, and the finance sector. Personally, I am telling you, I am going to invest in all these three sectors. And right now, I'm very much active in digital marketing and the finance. Now, my next step goes towards the retail sector. And I'm going to invest in that as well. And trust me, this is going to pay you high return. Just invest your time in your study. Because I found people, they ask me, Samar, give me some idea, what should I do? How can I tell what you should do? This is your call. You have to choose. I can only give you 5-10 options. That's all. You have to choose yourself what exactly motivates you, what exactly you are passionate for, what exactly motivates you to wake up in a midnight and just start working on your dream or start working on your things. Because money can't be a motivating factor only. I say that money should be the only byproduct, and your work should be your first love. If you are dedicated, if you are determined for your work, trust me, buddy, no one can stop you. No one. Because you will automatically get inspired for learning, for studying. Right now, if you follow my story, you would know that I told my story viewers. I get many viewers on my story, and sometimes more reach than my original post. So I told my story viewers that I have just joined a new intraday course. Why did I feel I need to learn? I could learn so many other things, but why did I feel I should go to intraday as well? Because in India, people has a sort of imagination in their mind that stock market is a gambling, which is untrue. Gambling is everything. If, for example, if you drive a car, if you attempt to drive a car and you don't know where is your brake, where is your escalator, and when you should push the brake while you get somebody, and when you should take your first gear. So this is also gambling. When you go outside and walking on a road nowadays in a corona time, that also gambling. Means gambling is when you don't know exactly what are you doing. This is what Warren Buffett had said. This is what every successful person says. And just I am following them and I admire them. So I am also saying the same thing. Stock market is gambling only for those people, those who don't know exactly what they have to, where they have to invest in, what they have to look at in, and they are not ready to study. Mostly people have this problem. They want a stock tips, but they don't get a stock guides. They don't want to read at all. Why? I just want to ask those people, why? Why do you need a trick? Why do you think everything would done by with a magic? It won't happen that way. If it happens, that is your luck. And maybe you should play the lottery for that thing, rather invest in stock market. So do not go with that route. Invest in your study, invest in your learning. My first rule and first advice for my young audience, young viewers, please, please, please invest your time for learning. You will definitely get humongous amount of money, humongous amount of education, and everything, whatever you ask for in your life.
And I just want to share something with you, this small experience which I happened based on your telling, is that I am quite active on TikTok. And TikTok, educational content over there. So I have somewhere around 1 lakh. So nowadays, everyone like, by viewers, how to get views, how to get likes. Okay. So 50% comments are on these, and the half 50% are like, bhai, paise kaise kamaye? How to earn money? How to earn money? Like, and they all are youngsters. They are not even 20. So everyone are like, I can't tell them suggestions. Like, I have ideas, but they need to execute. People nowadays are not executing. They want something instant. By sitting just few clicks, they need to get money. So that's the fun. I just comment them and then they're like, you don't know and all. So I just neglect that thing. So yeah, Samar. Coming to the next question is like, I was reading and I'm still reading and listening about exports and manufacturing is going to grow in India in coming years. As you told, in this coming decade in India, it's going to grow. So this exports and manufacturing, I'm reading. And I've seen a lot of opportunities, crazy things going to happen. So what's your take on this?
Can you repeat your question? I actually missed last thing.
Yeah, like I was reading about exports and manufacturing. So it tends to see that the incoming deal. Yeah.
I tell you one very interesting thing. You know, we used to think, we grew up with this thinking, export is very tough job. That I don't know from where got this idea in our brain that export business is very tough business and you do not get the clients very easily or you do not get the right way to export your products. You do not have a license facility, etc., etc. So we had a tremendous amount of negative approach about export business. But I tell you one thing. With only 4,000 rupees, you can immediately start your export business with just 4,000 rupees. Can you imagine? But the government, Narendra Modi, has told, spoken about this in last 15th August speech. He has told we can only achieve $5 trillion economy target once we have the export from every district of India. He is so much motivated and he is so much pushy about export. Why? Why you should export if you are a manufacturer or you are a trader? Because you have a better if you have a better product and a cheap labor, trust me, there are six outside of India, there are 650 crore people. Those who are ready to take your product, those who may consider your product, you are just settled down in 125 crore Indian domestic market and you think you would get the sufficient amount of business. No, you would get the business from those 650 crore people who are better in terms of money wise. Those who are better in terms of needs and those who are looking for those cheap products in a offer with a good quality in their city, in their home. They are looking for those products and you are just giving away to Indians. Like I'm a service exporter. I do service export of SEO, social media. I have few clients from US, UK, Australia. You name the country, I have the clients from there. And trust me, when you earn in a dollar na and spend in a rupee, that gives you the best motivation of your life. That gives you the humongous proud in you that you just used to hear these words in a movie and you are doing it right now for yourself, for your family, for your country. Because when you earn in a dollar, you give not only GST to government, but you bring the revenue from other countries to India. Means you bring the other currency to India. You give the strong base to Indian currency itself because the dollar is required to for a better currency position of India. So second, you give GST on your every transaction. This is completely white thing. You get the tax benefits from government side and you get the business in lockdown as well. That happens. Like my friend was saying, Samar, are you getting business nowadays? I said, yes, I'm getting it. And they said, buddy, hamara to sab band ho rakha hai. And how are you able to manage it? Because I do not target this 125 crore only. I have a humongous, huge target audience that sitting across the world, those who have the requirements won't get finished ever. Either lockdown happens or anything happens. Your business, of course, may get lower in this period, but it won't get finished. This is the power of export. And you need only 4,000 rupees if you become a trade exporter or some way. Only 4,000 rupees. What else you need, yaar? Matlab, just imagine about this thing. You need only 4,000 to become a crorepati. You have to just afford to bring the clients. That's all.
That 4,000 rupees is now kind of a pocket money. It's just a pocket money.
Yeah. If you invest, many institutes. There are free education provides by Indian government, and also there are many institutes, those who give export training, and many institute also commit you. They give the commitment that they will give you the business in return. If you invest 35,000 in the education with them, they guarantee you, they will give you the first order. They will bring the first order for you. This is the power of export business. I don't know where people are looking at, but this is the power of export business. Every Indian should consider export. Every Indian, either she is a woman or he is some guy sitting in some rural village, because India has tremendous value. No other country can serve in the manner like we Indians can. And trust on this thing.
Lovely. That was a crazy insights on exports. So yeah, coming to the next question, a student, basic student, maybe early 20s we can say, or someone who is doing a job at some age, 25, someone, and they don't have any idea about investment, about like if they want to invest on mutual fund or on stocks, get some share market, something you want to just put their fingers into that. Okay, so your basic thing, like how they can start with no knowledge, they don't have anything, how you can tell.
I give you the answer very, very quick for this. You have a 400 rupees. You have a 100 rupees in your pocket. After that 400 rupees, like from 500 rupees, you can start investing in stock market. What else you need here? If you are a student, if you are ready to study for stock market, and don't invest in stock market without study. That's mark my word. And if you are ready to invest in your study, 400 rupees, just go to Udemy.com. They have tremendous amount of courses on stock market, the Indian stock market. You learn from there and start investing in stock market from just 100 rupees. You can buy 100 stock of some company from stock market with just your 100 rupees. Is there any business in the world give you this freedom? I don't think so. With just 100 rupees, you can start your stock market career. What else you need? You need only determination. There are the ways. You have to start learning and growing. That's all you need.
And what I see as an investment is like, for example, I want to start my own company, but I don't have that budget. I don't have that much team and manufacturing unit all. But I have very little bit amount, which is like few thousand rupees. So instead of starting with that few thousands, I can start. So instead of starting with that, I can invest in the company which I wish to start. So that is kind of a investment. Like you are like a kind of a investor in their company. So people can have that kind of like as a mindset also. They can. This is what my perspective.
Great.
So like Samar, like what do you see the real estate business, the real investment, real estate as an investment in coming years?
See my hand, I'm rubbing my hand for podcast for those who can't see. I love real estate. Yeah, trust me, I come to know about real estate when I read Rich Dad Poor Dad. Okay. That book had changed my entire mindset about real estate. And today's period, trust me, we are living in such a brutal time where we already poured with opportunities. Everywhere there is opportunity. You know, you can start rental income from your own home. If you have a 3 rooms in your house and you are able to give 1 room to 1 guest, just list your room at airbnb.com and few other websites like booking.com, and trust me, they give you the guarantee that you would earn at least 35,000 rupees a month.
Look
at the USA. Just look at the USA. People are tremendously investing in Airbnb because travelers look. I tell you with my experience. Last year in December, I traveled 3 countries. That was Thailand, then Malaysia. Thailand, Singapore, then Malaysia. I have gone those 3 countries as a solo traveler, and from where I did the booking from Airbnb, and I am living in a 5-star property of Malaysia with just 1300 rupees a day.
Ooh. Damn cheap.
5-star property with just 1300 rupees a day. Brother, can you imagine this madness? That's the power of Airbnb, and that's what the travelers look. They do not look for comfort all the time. They just need the assurance of their safety. That's all. And this is what Airbnb is doing with you. You just offer the comfort to the expat guest in your home, and you will earn just to serve your guest. And the real estate investment, if you have a few lakhs rupees and you get the home loan, if you are eligible for home loan, this is the time you can invest in real estate. The real estate would give you the ROI, passive income, by itself. And if you ask for my investment, yet I am focused to commercial investment. I did in some other city in mall. So this was my plan that time when I did that. Now I am looking for the opportunity in home sector as well, to link myself with Airbnb and some other things.
Yeah, as we can see through technology, real estate have absolutely changed. Back then, real estate was only getting their plots or rents or giving them sale, building the whole flat and giving them the apartments and giving the sales. Now it's absolutely changed. If you have a small room in your home, apartment also, okay, that you can give. That's a crazy, that is what I think through technology has changed a bit.
And technology is giving you so much opportunity. For example, if you want to become a broker, let's say you know that rental business has a very big opportunity for these agents. Yeah. Just go to some Magic Breaks or few other websites. Just ask your neighborhood uncle auntie if you are interested to give your property on rent. I can help you. Just be the helping hand for others. List the property in Magic Breaks, 99 acres, and you will, if you are able to let's say turn their property into rental income for them, let's say 20,000 a month, you will get the 20,000 commission against it. This is the power of rental business. If you want
by sitting start at home, become a broker.
So you can start your own rental business as well. If you are ready to serve the people, just go through your neighborhood roads and ask uncle aunties that I can be helped to give you the tenant. You can just provide them the tenant online with just few calls a day. Just serve them and see you will start earning immediately. If somebody wants to earn in this age, they can earn. If they have the ton of excuses that either can't Amit be able to help you, neither I can do that.
True. And like in this way also, we can get commissions from both the side. If the deal is cracked, we can get as well from both sides getting entering into it.
So true.
Yeah. So like that was a lovely insight, and even I got to know something new. This the strategy which you gave, even I didn't know. Lovely thing. So I just want to know your idea, your like perspective or your thoughts on franchisees as an investment.
Yeah, again, you are touching the topics actually get increase my heartbeat because I and give me the goosebumps. I see this is the goosebumps I'm getting because I loved all these business. Like some if somebody would ask me, yeah, I have a money for investment, but I don't find anybody trustworthy to whom I can invest with. Yeah, don't trust an individual, nah. Invest in franchisee. You know, the franchisee business has so many models for passive income, for active income, for, other type of income. They can give you so many type of options and you need at least 20-30 lakh rupees investment. This is a reality about franchisee business. But if you have a money, spare money with you and you think you can earn with some company, so trust me, franchisee business has 95% of success rate. 95% of success rate, whereas other businesses have only 50 or 40% success rate. You can start it. Matlab, this is something I personally went to meet this franchisee India's company, and I went to their office. I met their Miss Neha, and she told me about the processes that different type of processes, and it was very exciting. And you can take their service. Like they charge you 30,000-40,000 rupees as a one-time fee, and they will give you, they will resolve your entire problem. They will get you the franchisee, they will get you the real estate, they will get you the right type of franchisee investment. They charge you a bit and give you high ROI. And this is not some penny company. This has a very good background, like Entrepreneur. Everybody read this magazine, yeah. Entrepreneur. And this is a company who support this, Franchisee India, who hold this company. So this is a very trustworthy model. Means every person who wants to earn passive income from a FOMO model or FICO model, you can earn passively. You don't want to invest time. Don't do that. Just earn passive income.
So guys, as we have seen, we have learned so much information. As I've told you in the initial, while starting the podcast, like every single minute we are going to learn, because by seeing the content, I have not spoke to this person before, but this is the first time. But initially at the starting podcast itself, I got to know I am, and we all are going to learn each and every minute. So thank you so much, Sama, for giving your valuable time, for your so much content. So yeah, so listeners, if you want to get connected, all the social handles of Samar are down in the description. So please go and check out. You're going to get so much value providing content over there. So guys, that's it from here, from my side and from Samar. See you in the another one. Until then, take care, keep smiling, and bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.